All right, now just really briefly concerning Rastafari Sanbet studies, this week's Torah portions, number 30. To them that say they are referred to as Kedoshim, to I and I as elect Rastafari in that pure language given to I and I. Be'amarenya, we would say Kedusan, Kedusan, being the plural of Kedus. And so this week's reading include Leviticus chapter 19 on towards the end of chapter 20. And the theme of this week's readings is the holy people, them that are holy, sacred, holy, separated to I and I creator, to our Lord God. We could even say Ketachin Jesus Christos Metchanetachin, being that the Father giveth all things to the Son, and what the Father hath given to the Son, no man can pluck out of the hand of the Son, basically. And so we continue on just by making mention that if we were to look up the word Kedus or Kedusan in the Amharic dictionary, we come to the understanding that it signifies saint, holy, blessed, sacred. And so, same as for Kedoshim, referring to the holy people, God's elect upon this earth. And so, we just mainly want to focus on the Haftarah, which would be how them that say they are would recognize the section, the portions of study within the books of the prophets. We as Rastafari would refer to this section as the Nebiyat. And so that is where we would like to focus our attention, need be the case. And for so long we've managed to overlook this seemingly small detail, but extremely significant. And it is the fact that we are directed to read Amos chapter 9 verse 7 as part of this week's Torah portion studies, which is entitled Kedoshim, Kedusan, the saints, the holy ones of Israel, the holy ones separated to the Lord our God. And behold, Amos chapter 9 verse 7, are ye not as children of the Ethiopians to me, O Israel? Need make mention that we're not reading off the scripture, but it basically is clear, obvious, and no excuses as to whom God compares his children to. In this case, he's comparing his those separated to him, his people Israel, comparing his children to the children of the Ethiopians, those separated from the nations, so that would maintain that pureness, and thus be for I and I in these latter days an example, that which we can follow. And so, basically, even more necessary to make mention is that those within the world seclorum recognize a certain people as Jews, right? So they that say they are, and we're not saying they're not, but once must prove themselves to be. And so those of we basically we're referring to those of Israeli status. And so we know we got to give it to them, we got to hand it to them, give them credit. They most many of them maintain the Sabbath. They do diligence as to keeping studies, and they align themselves fairly well to keeping the customs and traditions handed to them from their ancestors. So what we're trying to say is that there is very little possibility, if any, that them that say they are not aware of whom the Most High himself compares his children Israel to. And the answer is the Ethiopians. So basically, We know that them that say they are know this, and so we ask you in all kindness and all in love, with the spirit of friendship and in Jesus Christos, we would ask and advise and recommend that ones that claim to be speak truth for what it is, and thus prove themselves to be. If those are known, are well known or knowledgeable in these facts that are very obvious and very clear, then it is our duty to speak out and publicate the word of truth, regardless of where upon this earth that I may be. Ones must not be ashamed of the word of truth. If truth be what it be, then nothing else can be. The Most High set it up to be as such, and so we must not be ashamed, not back down, and declare those things that are right, just, in the eyes of our Creator, for it is He whom decided all things. There's no way around it. So basically, not only is it a duty that we speak the truth, just really briefly, kind of like a side note, it takes us forward to the Garden of Eden. Adam was ashamed and he did not speak up. First of all, he didn't teach those surrounding him. We are to teach, we are to feed our fellow brothers and sisters within the human community. We are to feed them with that food from heaven, with that higher foods, we could say. And so that is, I guess, like a basic principle of the matter. Secondly, would be that Adam was ashamed and refused to stand for that which is just. He kept silent like a lamb to, being led to the slaughter, not opening that mouth, one of those seals which his Creator had given him, as has given I and I, to proclaim and declare those things which are of our Creator. And so we ask those that claim to be, in this world recognized as Jews with Israeli status. We're aware, and we can rightly assume that you're aware of whom Israel is likened to, so just speak out, and if not for the previous stated facts, then at least do it for those surrounding you, those within the human community that have not been that have been disfortunate in the sense that have not had the opportunity to even hear the truth, much less to make a proper decision, informed decision as to how to proceed once having heard the truth. Many excuse me, many really do seek to live that life which our Creator requires us to live, but they many are have not had the opportunity to learn truth for what it was, and oftentimes it is because of those that know it and keep it hidden, or just refuse to speak it to the public as is. And so it is not fair for those that continue in error ignorantly, because some of us that do know are cannot muster the courage to speak the truth of our Creator. And so we owe it to our brothers and sisters within this human community to declare that which is true, and thus giving everyone an equal opportunity to decide as to what to do once having heard the truth. And once know, then all blame is pretty much individual. Ones can decide to accept truth and live in the spirit of truth in Jesus Christus, or ones can refuse it. But at least that decision was informed, and not like many of our peoples around the world that follow these religions that keep from them the truth. And it's not to go against religions, it's to go against the withholding of evidence, of truth, of fact, of right, of just, of the righteousness that is Jesus Christus, basically. And so, like many of them, continue in error for they are not knowledgeable in truth. And so we ask not only them that say they are to prove themselves to be by doing that which is required of we, but we also speak this to Ras Tefari, you know. So very obvious this week's Torah portion concerning the saints, and whom does our Lord God compare his elect people, his children Israel, to the Ethiopians, that example, Imperial Ethiopia, you know. And so with that, we could pretty much, so okay, one I guess one little last matter, last commentary comment. David had asked the Most High a question. If we were to go on forward to 2 Samuel chapter 7 verse 23, David asked our Creator, governor of this universe, what one country, what one nation is in upon this earth is like thine people, even like Israel. Amos 9 and 7, you know, behold, are ye not as children of the Ethiopians to me, O Israel?